On hot copy this morning, a bill that criminalizes red tagging has been filed at the Senate. One of the most recent and most controversial incidents is when officials from the Anti-Communist Task Force accused organizers of some community pantries of being part of a communist movement. Joining us now for his thoughts on this, we have Justice Secretary Menardo Guevara. Justice Secretary, good morning to you, sir.
Hi, Karen. Good morning, and good morning to your televiewers.
All right. Justice Secretary Guevara, you support Senate Minority Leader Franklin Drelon's bill, citing the need for a law criminalizing red tagging. You believe a law is needed?
Karen, of course, if Congress is minded to investigate and prosecute actual acts, which are loosely called red tagging at this time, then the appropriate legislation should be enacted. Because right now, yung mga acts considered or deemed red tagging ay hindi siya punishable exactly for what it is. No? So parang the best that could be done would be to file complaints which are somehow related but not directly fitting to the act being complained of. So that's really congressional initiative or policy. If they want to prosecute people who do red tagging, then the appropriate legislation should be passed.
Are you already alarmed, Secretary Guevara, at the level of red tagging that's been happening coming from certain government officials at this point?
Well, in the past few months, medyo sunod-sunod, no, yung mga reklamo about red tagging. So, people have raised their voice against it. So, might as well have won, because the frequency of these acts, loosely called red tagging, has really become quite disturbing, if I may say.
So you find it quite disturbing. Do you believe in any way that this is attached in some way because of the Anti-Terror Act?
Karen, medyo not so clear because of my connectivity here. You're saying, are you asking if it's in any way related to the anti-terrorism law or the current hearings going on in the Supreme Court?
Yes. I'm asking if you believe that with the Anti-Terror Act, government officials, specifically the NTFL-CAC, are more brazen to red tag, to red bait, because specifically of the anti-terror law?
Well, I cannot really speculate on what's in the mind of people in our security sector, no? But there may be some point to the argument that because there is a provision in the anti-terrorism law about recruitment and membership in terrorist organizations and punishes those acts accordingly, eh baka pang may relate niya, no? The present what's happening now, na parang certain persons or group of persons are being tagged as communists or terrorists or subversives or enemies of the state. Meron kasing relevant provision or related provision in the anti-terrorism law. Remember that there was this law before, Republic Act No. 1700, or the Anti-Subversion Law, no, which was passed originally in 1957, which outlawed the Communist Party of the Philippines. And this law, this Anti-Subversion Act, was expanded, and the penalties, therefore, were increased substantially during the period of martial law. So, noong 1992, this law, Anti-Subversion Act, was repealed. And therefore, wala na ngayon, at that point, no, wala na yung batas which outlawed the CPP, the Communist Party of the Philippines, and the NPA. And wala nang, hindi na siya a criminal act to be a member of the Communist Party of the Philippines. So, wala na yun ngayon. So, mere membership hindi na punishable until dumating yung anti-terrorism law, which penalizes membership in a terrorist organization. So, whether or not yung current red tagging had anything to do with it, I really cannot speculate on what's on the mind, no, in the mind of the people in our security sector. But there is reason to believe that baka mayroong linkage somehow.
Kumbaga, is it fair to say na posibleng lumakas ang loob ng ating security sector mag-red tag dahil po sa batas na ito?
That is very possible, Karen, no? Dahil nga sabi ko sa iyo, nung dati merong batas na nag-outlaw ng CPP and then nawala na yung batas na yon. So pwedeng mag-join ng CPP, maybe even the NPA without much fear. But now that with the anti-terrorism law, recruitment and membership will be punished. Kaya parang it's fair to say na baka may relation nga, no, yung current red tagging activities, so-called.
Now, General Esperon has already he's issued a gag order against General Parlade, the spokesperson, for a series of red tagging that he's issued against certain individuals, including community pantry organizers and even certain personalities in the past. I'm curious if at any point any complaints against General Parlade has been brought to your office.
Well, Karen, none so far, no? As far as the DOJ is concerned, wala pa kaming natatanggap na any complaint for red tagging, no, against any person. Particularly si General Parlade. Siguro the reason for this is dahil nga wala namang exactly na batas right now against red tagging. So the best that can be filed would be complaints for libel or defamation or threat or coercion, yeah, and stuff like that. But none for red tagging because precisely there's no law defining and punishing red tagging.
Now, Senator Drilon believes that President Duterte should certify this as urgent. Now, we have to see that if the president would agree with that. But do you believe that this is urgent? Would you consider this urgent, Secretary?
From a procedural point of view, Karen, merong particular time during the legislative process that a certification of urgency might be issued, no? And that's at the point, I think, where at least tapos na sa committee level at nakaroon na ng first reading and it's now supposed to be on second reading para ma-accelerate together with the third reading. So that's the purpose. I think the time that a certificate of urgency may be requested and issued, no, by the chief executive. But from a substantial point of view, alam mo, kasi meron ng naka-lay down na legislative priorities ang current administration, Karen, no? So I think the administration or the president will most likely follow itong legislative agenda, yung priority set laid down in this legislative agenda of current administration. And definitely, itong matter of the anti-red tagging bill does not fall in that legislative agenda. Kaya, of course, that's the prerogative of the president, Karen, no? He may or may not grant the request to certify the bill as urgent. But looking at the current priorities of this present administration, I mean its legislative agenda, it doesn't look very probable na mag-issue ang presidente ng certificate of urgency. Anyway, you know, the reason for this, Karen, is kung wala pa naman yung batas na yan against red tagging, meron namang ibang other criminal offenses that may be charged na somehow related but not exactly on the against the acts defined as red tagging, no, in the bill ni Senator Trillon.
Okay. On another note, Congressman Mike Defensor and Congressman Marcoleta have plans, I think it is today, to distribute ivermectin through their community PAN3s. So that's the name actually, it's PAN3. I'm really curious, under the law, is this allowed?
Karen, under the existing FDA law, the importation, sale, distribution, or administration of unregistered drugs or vaccines are prohibited, no, and accordingly punished. So we know that ivermectin is not registered for use by humans because apparently ginagamit siya for animals, no, for parasitic diseases of animals. So in the case of ivermectin, it's not registered particularly as a drug against COVID-19. And going by the FDA law, on its face, it would appear that the distribution of ivermectin as a possible treatment for COVID-19 apparently violates the FDA law. However, the FDA itself, through its director general, has declared, maybe under its own rules, no, I'm not too sure about that, Karen,
yes,
that ivermectin may be allowed in certain situations, no, and he identified these two situations. Number one is when it is covered by a compassionate use authorization issued to specific hospitals, doctors, or other entities. And the other situation is when ivermectin is compounded by duly licensed pharmacies and its use is supported by a doctor's prescription. So if Representative Defensor and Representative Marcoleta's act of distributing ivermectin would fall under any of these two situations, it would appear that they can put this up as a defense just in case a complaint is filed against them. But personally, I'm not too sure whether these two exemptions cited by the FDA Director General have a sound legal basis. So that is something that is for further study. No, I'm not too sure about the soundness of the legal basis for the exemptions.
So would you warn Congressman Mike Defensor at this point not to push through?
Well, at this point, no, considering na meron niyang sinabi mismo yung Director General ng FDA na provided na the ivermectin to be distributed is compounded by a duly licensed pharmacist and is supported by a doctor's prescription per person to receive the ivermectin, then coming from the FDA Director General himself, who is supposed to be the biggest expert, no, on these matters, then I wouldn't really blame Representative Defensor and Marcoleta if they would proceed, no. But as I said, this is subject to a further determination if there is legal basis for the exemption. So I leave it to them. I think their purpose is they're well meaning in what they want to do, but then well, the legal consequences, that's something for us to see at a future time.
All right. On that note, Justice Secretary Minardo Guevara, we don't have enough time this morning, but I do hope to speak with you again, other issues in the coming weeks, including I know you will be meeting with my representatives of Maynilad soon to discuss the new contract. So I hope to follow up on that, Secretary.
Okay. Thank you, Karen.
All right. God bless you, sir. You take care. Thank you.